Come on, people. What is more 70s than this cover? It actually came out in 1970. It's Company! Or when you hear Lance Stritch in the close-up on the microphone, Company. You know, the crazy, where she's like, way too close to the microphone, we love you. We're not going to focus on that. We're going to focus on another 100 people, the amazing Pam Myers, her first Broadway show. She was like 20. And she auditioned for the show, and Stephen Sondheim was like, I'm writing a song for you. And she was like, really? I just voided. Luckily, she was wearing Depends, and everything worked out okay. And he wrote this song, Another 100 People, for her. It's such a perfect New York song. For some reason, people always sing New York, New York is a big New York song, but everyone should be like, Another 100 People, with the crazy sing-along. But anyway, it's such a New York song. I love so many things about it. First of all, the melody goes up in thirds. You know, another 100 people to get off of the train and came out through the ground wall. Another 100 people to get off of the bus and are looking around at another 100 people. I love the major seven. All right. I would say it's Color My World, Chicago. Any Chicago fans? No? Okay. I also love the accompaniment slash that was then turned into the orchestration. So like, I think it's it again. I'm always going to say everything is bassoon. It's either the bassoon or the bass clarinet going like. If you watch the Making of the Company cast album, you see the person. I can't remember what he's playing with the. Well, first of all, you see them playing the instruments, and you see them literally smoking a pack. They're all like, boom, boom. It's the 70s. We all smoke. We didn't know it was bad for us. Really? I think it's pretty obvious that you have smoke going into your butt. Anyway, so I think it's like a bassoon or something. Then you hear the guitars going like, but some crazy, amazing eighth note thing. I can't play it quite. And then the other syncopation is. So together, it's like. It's so like the hustle and bustle of New York. Like it's so when it'd be like, another 100 people just got off. You're like, terrible. It's, we're hustling and bustling. We're eighth notes and we're syncopated. Okay, we're gonna hear all that. And the final thing you have to listen to is she adds vibrato on, Maybe Yesterday. Okay, I have to actually find it. It's the only problem on my iPod. Another 100, there it is. Okay, hit it.
Got off of the train.
What?
The plane and
sorry.
The bus.
Here we go. Guitar.
Another 100 people just got off of the train and
up
came up through the ground while another 100 people just got off of the bus and are looking around at another 100 people who got off of the plane and are looking at us who got off of the train and the plane and the bus maybe yesterday.
Vibrato. Okay. It's such great, great, great lyrics. Okay. It really is, you know, the whole, that lyric, It's a City of Strangers, the whole song just has that very kind of, not winter, but very autumny, depressing feel. And at the same time, like, the vibrance of New York, but definitely the crazy distance. It just, it so sounds like with the A minor chord. It's a city of strangers. Oh, so pretty. Okay, so sing City of Strangers. The strings come in there, so you hear the strings, and then the strings do this crazy trill. You never hear low trills in a string, but you'll hear a crazy low trill, that amazing full string section, delicious scale, you're gonna hear that. Then I love the rhyme that she talks about the guarded. It sounds like guided, but it's guarded parks. So it's like the parks are dangerous. We have to have guards. Guarded parks, trees with battered barks. It's so depressing. And the walls are splattered with crude remarks. It's an amazing triple rhyme. Like a lot of times you hear a triple rhyme and there'll be one word, you're like, that was forced in there. But all those three are amazing. Guarded parks, battered barks, crude remarks. Okay, here we go.
It's a city of strangers. Some come to work, some to play. A city of strangers.
Low trill.
And every day, the ones who stay
scale.
Can find each other in the crowded streets and the guarded parks. By the rusty fountains and the dusty trees with the battered barks. And they walk together past the postured walls with the crude remarks.
Okay, then amazing string line comes in. Ba da 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 da. This beautiful string line is coming in. So it's like, you have sort of the brass is going, am I right? Yeah, the brass is going like bung, gung, gung. So the muted brass is doing that syncopation, bung, gung, 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 gung. The woobens are going, ticka, 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 ticka. So the woobens are doing the crazy, and of course, it's still the bung, gung in the bass. And the beautiful string line on top is just this beautiful, beautiful line. So at the very end, it's this crazy clash, but then it winds up being her last note. So it's so pretty. You're like, why is it clashing? Why is it clashing? Oh my God, it's her same note. Amazing moment. And I think I have to tell you, oh yeah. I am obsessed with the distance, the crazy emotional intimacy issues. It's like, will you pick me up? Will I meet you there? Shall we let it go? Like, literally, while she's making plans, she cancels the plans. Will you pick me up or do I meet you there? Shall we let it go? Like, wait, but I was in the middle of making plans. It's over. I'm obsessed with that, the crazy intimacy issues. And I also love how dated the show is. Like, I'll call you in the morning or my service will explain. Really? We don't, have answers. I just love that it's so 1970. Literally the whole show begins with a busy signal. So it's like right there, like, and 1970. So anyway, here we go. Right on the right thing. I walk together. I'm just nervous. I think I'm right. Yeah, okay, this is it, right? Maybe yesterday. No, here we go. Press the postured walls with a crude remorse. There goes a beautiful string line. And they made it parties through the friends of friends, who they never know. Will you pick me up or do I meet you there? Shall we let it go? Did you get my message? Because I looked in vain. Can we see each other Tuesday if it doesn't rain? Cook will call you in the morning or my service will explain. Okay, amazing lyric. Would you hear that? Did you hear the string line? Shall we let it go? Did you get my message? Because I looked in vain. Can we see each other Tuesday if it doesn't rain? Cook will call you in the morning or my service will explain. Right back.
And another 100 people just cut off of the train.
God, it's so chilling. It's such great lyrics. Okay, the next section, she comes back in with it. It's a city of strangers. That, you know, it's this. Oh, so pretty. She comes back in with that, but now, Sondheim style, he's like, I'm not going to be old school and literally repeat every single lyric, like old musicals, where it's like, we just repeat the same song 3 times till you like it. He changes it. Instead of, and every day, the ones who stay, he makes it refer to the character of Kathy because she says at the beginning of the scene, or yeah, right before, because this song is broken up into 3 sections. Anyway, she tells the lead character that she's moving out of New York. She's like, you know what? I can't take it anymore. So she sings, and every day some go away. So it refers to her depressing choice to leave town. Here, listen to this.
And another 100 people just cut off of the train.
Back to the bridge. Slight change.
It's a city of strangers. Some come to work, some to play.
Okay,
a city of strangers. Some come to stare, some to stay.
And it's hard.
And every day.
Now listen to the crazy gravitas that she adds to that phrase, as opposed to the beginning when she goes, and every day, the ones who stay, like nothing could go wrong. Okay, so here's the original version of that. Listen to this.
And every day, the ones who stay.
Everything's fun. Really? 2 minutes later, it's devastating. Now listen to the crazy Sturm und Drang depression that she adds. Okay, here we go.
A city of strangers, some come to stare, some to stay. And every day.
Take a Paxil. Okay, so then the last verse, or they, so now I love the beautiful strings, or they, a beautiful scale goes with her. And then they add a very tip of the hat to Promises, Promises. In this show, they have orchestra voices. So they have just 3 girls who can sing with a wonderful straight tone. I guess it's impressive. Sing in the background, like, oh. I don't, it's sort of, it just adds this weird sound to the orchestra. Or they find each other, and she's like, oh. It's very Promises, Promises. So listen to that. And then the most brilliant thing that happened. Well, so, by the way, they also add a cool drum part. It's like, finally, they're rocking out. But the most brilliant thing that Jonathan Tunick, who's the orchestrator, does. He takes the opening number, and the show is about this guy named Bobby, who's a bachelor that everybody's obsessed with. So the whole opening number goes, Bobby, 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 baby, Bobby, booby, Robbie, Robert, darling, Robbie, come on over for dinner. Da-da-da-da. He takes that and puts it in the accompaniment of another 100 people. Now, it's not anything you're going to notice as an audience member, literally, but if you listen to it 8,000 times a day, like I did, you will notice it. And obviously, subconsciously, you're noticing it. So what it represents is just like this crazy, like the hussing and bustling of New York and how like Bobby's everywhere. So as she's singing, you hear the trumpets going, ba-dum, ba-dum, ba-da-da-da, ba-dum, ba-dum, ba-dum. Mary Sunshine? Okay, here we go. Unbelievable. Listen to the scale first. Hold on.
Ah, sorry. Of course.
Who can straight tone with the best of them? Drums. That's amazing. That's the part. Jonathan Tunick.
Is
it clashing? Not for long. And then just back.
And another 100 people just got off of the train.
And then finally, It's just that symbolic ending that it just never ends. A la in a chorus line, when they're doing the kick line for one, it's supposed to be like the kick line never ends. I don't know if you know that, but the end of a chorus line is supposed to be like, it goes on and on. Same thing with this. And another 100 people, she just keeps repeating it. Another 100 people, then up a third, and another 100 people just get off of the train. Then finally she ends in the seventh. Another 100 people just get off of the train, and the company is going crazy. It's this craziness around her. And then I'd say it's tip of the hat to Stephen Schwartz, like a Pippin ending, even though it's actually predated Stephen Schwartz. I guess Stephen Schwartz gives tip of the hat. But the point is, it's very, you know, extraordinary. You know, like the end of Stephen Schwartz stuff, he always does that weird, like, so same thing, like, she goes, another people got off of the train. Stephen Schwartz. Okay, here we go. It's crazy to say Stephen Schwartz when this came out before. Sorry, but I heard Pippin before I ever heard this. Therefore, in my mind, Stephen Schwartz came up with it. Okay, here we go.
And another 100 people just got off of the train.
Now it starts out of an item.
And another 100 people just got off of the train. And another 100 people just got off of the train. And another 100 people just got off of the train. Another 100 people just got off of the train.
Pippin? What? Okay. Bye-bye, company. Thumbs up.